Let's hear it for a trombone solo, Jeremy Sings. And again, our piano player, Keith Miller. This number, everybody always tells me when we have park concerts, don't put it on, because if we do, we're tempting fate. And sure enough, today, it was raining. So we're going to do Here's That Rainy Day, a number that was made famous by Stan Kenton. Lots of folks to acknowledge on that one. That was a beautiful number. First of all, our trombone section. It doesn't get any better than that. Dave Stickley on trumpet solo. And Liz Ebert on keyboards. Back in the 30s, one of the first women composers in the jazz field did a number that was written for the Benny Goodman Band, specifically at the behest of their sponsor, Camel Cigarettes. Mary Lou Williams wrote Camel Hop, and I think you'll enjoy this. It's kind of a throwback to the 1930s. was good stuff, the old stuff. Now we're going to move back to the 70s. Country Road, another Maynard Ferguson specialty. Randy Murray, Maynard Ferguson. Okay, I promised us some hip-hop rock type stuff, so you'll recognize this one. I don't think I need to introduce it.
Thank you.
Told you we would do some of that. We'll change moods now that you're all hyped up. We'll do something a little more romantic. Christopher Brown, our Barry sax player, will be soloing on Willow Weep For Me.
Thank you.
Not only do you play that really well, but if you ever tried to lift that thing, it's really heavy.
Can I sleep now?
One more, and then you're off. Johnny Mercer wrote this tune. Ella Fitzgerald and Frank Sinatra made it famous, and it's still sung to this day by many, many, many crooners, particularly if you go to Vegas. Tangerine. That was Jim Carson. Woo! He's not a fan club. We hope you enjoyed this inaugural formal jazz band concert. And we thank you. Thank you. On behalf of everybody. Our next performances, of course, will be outdoors, so pray for no rain. We won't publish or put on Here's That Rainy Day. Next time we'll be out on the 4th of July, as we have been for the last 18 years, at the Rotary Green at 7 o'clock, and be playing a patriotic and show tunes and some classical concert with our symphonic band as a lead-in into the fireworks. So bring your picnic baskets, your lawn chairs, get ready for a wonderful evening. It doesn't dare rain. It never has on the 4th of July in 18 years. I know, I just jinxed it. It won't happen. It won't happen. Then on July 14th, we'll be playing a concert in Mundelein at Cracklauer Park. They have a beautiful band shell over there. We enjoy playing there. This will be our third year doing this in the summer. So come out for that. And then this is new. It hasn't been published on the website because we only got the date just a couple days ago. On November 16th, we'll be playing our fall concert. It's going to be From the Old World to the New. That's the tentative title. There will be a lot of wonderful symphonic works on that from the symphonic band and a couple numbers from the jazz band. And then our Christmas concerts. And then next year, we hope to have our formal concert back at Stevenson on April 19th, and then another jazz band concert here in May. So we have a full plate. We're scheduled out to next May, and I hope you enjoy what we're doing for Buffalo Grove, because we enjoy doing it, and we enjoy bringing it to all of you. So to finish up for tonight, we're going to go back to the famous 1938 Carnegie Hall concert. Benny Goodman started the jazz craze by playing in Carnegie Hall, their first formal concert, with Sing, Sing, Sing.